This video, we are going to talk about excess sebum in scalp and hair thinning. Sebum is an oily secretion that moisturizes your hair and forms a hydrolipid layer that acts like a waterproofing system for your hair shaft. So it's very important in preventing loss of nutrients and oils which are naturally present in your hair to environment, as well as it gives protection to hair against environmental pollutants. So it's important in keeping your hair shining and healthy. The problem is that when your sebaceous glands become hyperactive, they start to produce too much sebum, and this excess sebum can start to get accumulated in the excretory duct of your hair follicle, and this can clog the hair follicle and impair the oxygen delivery at the root of your hair. So when your hair is not receiving enough oxygen supply, what is going to happen, that this can lead to thinning of hair, and if you do not correct this, this can lead to permanent loss of hair. So why your sebaceous glands are producing so much sebum? Why they have become uncontrolled? This has to do with your altered host response, and this is coming from leaky gut, or in medical term we call it as increased intestinal permeability. So in this case, what happens, that there is increased seepage of toxins, pathogens, antigens which are present in your colon, and they enter into the blood and they react with your blood proteins and lead to altered host immune response. So in that case, your sebaceous glands can become hyperactive and start to produce too much sebum. So if you want to get rid of this condition permanently, you have to fix your gut. I have done detailed videos on gut health, you can check that in my playlist. Here briefly I'll tell you that in order to fix leaky gut, you have to avoid stress. Stress is the number one culprit that can increase the intestinal permeability. Avoid precipitating factors like alcohol, smoking. Then in genetically predisposed individual, gluten and dairy, these two proteins can make things worse, because if you are genetically predisposed, then these two types of protein can damage the villi of your intestinal cells, and that can increase leaky gut. So you have to follow an elimination diet at least for 3 months. So start eliminating gluten and dairy. Next thing that is very important is enhancing the formation of tight junctions. These tight junctions will not allow toxins to seep into blood, and for this particular thing, vitamin D is very, very important, and in fact vitamin D could be a game changer here. Next, you want to seal the lining, this, and for this, vitamin A and L-glutamine, these two are very, very important. It's also very important to eat colorful fruits and vegetables to get flavonoids like quercetin, which is important for your gut health. If your gut is healthy, it means that your liver is healthy, because these two are interconnected by portal vein. And if your gut is unhealthy, your liver will be unhealthy, and if your liver is unhealthy, that means the chances of metabolic syndrome are very high. And in observational studies, it has been seen that those people who have excess sebum in the scalp have metabolic syndrome. And I would recommend you to go for a thorough investigation, and I would recommend you to go for lipid profile and liver function test and ultrasonography abdomen, so that you want to know your HDL cholesterol and triglycerides, because observational studies have pointed out that excess sebum in scalp is associated with decrease in HDL cholesterol and increase in triglycerides. So it's important to replace your unhealthy fat with healthy fats like ghee or coconut oil or butter or olive oil, and avoid eating refined sugar. Refined sugar can increase triglycerides and precipitate these things. Then you have to exercise to increase your HDL cholesterol, and get good sleep to increase HDL cholesterol, because HDL cholesterol is seen to be on the lower side in people dealing with this particular condition. And also you want to rule out fatty liver. This is very, very important. Second important thing is optimize your omega 6 to omega 3 ratio, and this is one of the important causes of inflammation, especially in urban India. India is consuming too many omega 6 rich food and not getting enough omega 3. It is estimated that urban Indian population is getting 50:1 ratio, which is crazy, because you want to decrease the omega 6 consumption and increase omega 3 to bring the ratio as close as possible, and it is recommended to bring the ratio close to 4:1. So you have to increase this omega 3 and decrease omega 6. This could also give you protection against a lot of inflammatory diseases, cardiovascular diseases like heart attack, stroke, and inflammation of joints and hair fall and acne. So improve this ratio. Third thing is avoiding precipitating factors. So direct application of heat, then harsh chemicals present in your hair products or shampoos, then over shampooing. So you want to avoid all these things because this can stimulate your sebaceous gland to make more sebum. Then you should use a ketoconazole shampoo 1 to 2 times weekly, or even you can use apple cider vinegar shampoo and use it by mixing with few drops of tea tree oil. Next thing that is commonly seen is that if you have excess sebum in scalp, you have high DHT in scalp, and high DHT in scalp means increased likelihood of getting male pattern baldness. Although it is just an observation, but still you have to be extra careful here because you have to assume that you are having high DHT if you have excess sebum, and you have to take natural DHT blockers like zinc, then lycopene rich food, then healthy fat from walnuts, omega 3 rich food, all those green tea. So all these things you have to include in your diet, which are natural DHT blockers if you are dealing with excess sebum in scalp. But the key is this. So you have to fix your gut health in order to get rid of this condition, and maybe in order to reverse male pattern baldness. Thank you.